because a lot of stuff actually are the same
Yep.
the same verses, the same basically. So I'm gonna be repeating. So since we are teaching,
that's
this is
good.
So
yeah.
If you hear
yeah.
me, you know, referencing the same thing, that's good, because
yeah.
that means we can remember it, right?
Yes.
You know, learning is actually through repetition. That's the reason why, you know, I was just in training this morning, and I don't want to do this like I'm teaching. So if I call you to, because I don't want to do like interaction, like this training this week, I basically have to do it to know that, you know, what this teaching is, you know, what is teaching actually transferring, because basically transferring what we've learned being a worship leader. So what we, I want to just go through my stuff and you know, interject some of the stuff that they already. So on John 4:23-24, this is the same thing that the hour is coming when it says worship him in spirit and in truth. And Mom mentioned this about in my also about this being in spirit, and so I just want to make sure that you guys totally understand what's saying meaning in spirit, right? Worship in spirit, because I remember when we were actually a while ago, you know, when 4 years ago, you know, well, like a year out, we were starting the worship team. There's a lot of new members, and so on our teaching, we would say, okay, what is worship and what is praise? And so we're saying like worship, praise, do fast song. You know, worship, do slow songs. You know, so in essence, actually, it's, you know, it's correct. That's what we're doing, right?
Yeah,
right. So, and then as we go our next training, it's not. You know, praise is when you give praise. It doesn't mean a song anymore. You know. So it's there's a step when you go, okay, now right now we'll learn about two songs, and then so the next thing you have a better understanding, oh, it's not about the fast song or the slow song, it's about what you're saying on the song. It's about giving him praise. You know, it could be a fast song, you know, great are you Lord, it's a slow song, but basically you're giving praises to him, right?
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. And then the another thing that Pastor brought this one. In South, we see that last week, right? Which is very good. When we give praise, when we sing in our spirit, you know, I'm always trying to be like, when we're doing it, right? So when we're doing it, this is like, okay, when we sing a song, you know, when I sing a song, he says, it's very important that it's in your range, right? So if it's in your range, because otherwise, if it's not in your range, a voice, a song is always in a range. When you say key of G, that means my song is always key of G and A. Because pagdating ng B or C, it's too high. Like, Brother Ted sang that song in C. I couldn't sing a song that's key of C. Because it's very high when you explode it. So what happens is, when it's too high, it's all up here because you cannot belch out, coming up from the belly, right? Because what we're supposed to sing when we sing, you know, release the fool. It has to come out from here. Release the fool. Pag nataas masyado, release the fullness. You know, so you're basically like right here. You're squeezing it, you know. So I want to share that to you so that you know that the song, there's a key. So that you can properly transpose it,
yep.
Right? Properly transpose it, because, but if we're singing it here, we sing songs that actually, you either it's too high for, if it's key for Maya, it'll be too high for me, so I have to go down, which is okay, because she's leading, right? You just have to back up. But if you're singing it on your own personal worship, because now, this is what we're talking about, like corporate worship, right? So if you're personal, sing the song that it's already in you, you know? Sing the song, even if it's very old song, you know? Like for me, I was learning the song and I says, and then I started thinking, like, man, this song, this new song is not about us, about me, you know? Like, even the song that I wrote for myself, like, you know, you know, take me higher. And it's true, because I wanted to, you know, it's a song that I was singing to God. But, you know, it would have been better if you're basically lifting up God, you know. So I actually started seeing that just, you know, a month ago. And I started to sing this, "Let the glory of the Lord." And it just, and then Christine would tell me, like, "Babe, you keep saying that song, well, it's very simple. I keep, you know, my God reign, our God reign, you know, Lord, you reign above every name." You know, so, you know, you lift it up,
yes.
You know, in the mornings, man, I can, like, walking now, it's like, okay, a song like this, you know, our God reign. You know, so go back, if it's an old song, even if it's an old song, right? You know, when you wake up in the morning, you begin your prayer, because when we pray, we're talking a lot about corporate worship and personal worship. I want to share to you that there's also waiting. It's kind of like basically the same stuff. I'm not going through my notes. But there are stuff. Because Maya was saying God is a God of order, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what this mom was saying, that there is waiting. Waiting is important. And then before you even wait, I think it's better even if you set an appointment. Set a time, you know, set a time
mm-hmm.
in a day.
Mm-hmm.
Like in the morning maybe. But, you know, if like me, like I'm living in an apartment, I don't want to wake up my neighbors. So sometimes the waiting for me, the waiting, you can play a song, you can play, I used to go to the closet and play the pads, you know, like rubber pads here, like the one that Myra was saying, or just light song, like piano keyboard on the background, just play it light, and I'm just wait until I feel that there's something different in my surroundings. I can feel the presence of God. And then I started praying, I started praising and praising and praising and praising, you know. And I said, okay, where do I get my praise? Where do you get
mm-hmm.
your praise? And so I said, okay, where do I get my praise? Maybe Psalms. You know, starts reading the Psalms, because the book, in the Psalms, is there's a lot of praise.
Yes.
There. So just continue, you know,
mm-hmm.
deposit it in, deposit and deposit and deposit.
Yeah.
So that when your time to pray, just give it back. The word, give it back. Those are the praises. You can start with that. You can start also start with reading,
mm-hmm.
right? So that is my reading while waiting. Now I tried not playing the pads, not playing this thing. So I just start reading. You know, I'll start reading. So I could read like maybe a couple verses, or I could read like four chapters before I start something that I read. And I was like, okay. You know, I can start feeling like, wow, there's something in that verse that speaks to
mm-hmm.
me. Right? So, and then I start praying from there, you know. It is important on waiting. As you can see that we were waiting also when we were here.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes it can get like, oh, what is going to happen? You know, we become anxious, right? We become anxious. And that's why it is very important that we have to listen. This is the biggest, you know. So it's a conversation. So when what we do is,
mm-hmm.
when we give praise, it's our time to give praise. It's
mm-hmm.
our time to talk, you know,
mm-hmm.
declare,
mm-hmm.
declare, declare, declare. It's our time to talk. And when we wait, you know, when we're done talking, then it's our time to listen.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Then it's our time to listen. So it's actually also, you know, you can do it, but you can also do it in personal. You know, start listening what God's telling you.
Yeah.
Even when we were worshiping, when we worshiped last Sunday, right? At Reseda, you know, I'm into this new thing like prophetic and word of knowledge,
mm-hmm.
and you know, Pastor Linda actually spoke about you know, word of knowledge, a prophetic about something going on, and someone here, God's telling me. So you can start learning that, because it's God will talk to you about
mm-hmm.
someone else, some of your family. You know, someone that
right.
you know, someone in this room.
Right.
So we need to really sharpen and leaning our, you know, our hearing. Sharpen the discernment, sharpen our hearing, Lord. Is that you, or is that
yeah.
just what I ate last night, you know? you know, you want to make sure that you're always leaning. It always falls back. If I always if I study that, it becomes like walking in spirit. Mm. You know, walking in spirit, right? It's every, you know, moment by moment, always leaning into Him. Mm. You know, leaning into Him. And that's because when we worship in spirit, you have to be partner with the Spirit.
Yes.
Right? You always have to partner with the Spirit. Because God says, God is spirit, and, you know, worship is must worship in spirit and in truth.
Amen.
Amen. Wow. Okay, so, let me see, I have to go back in my notes. So, okay, worship, we already said about, you know, the reason why we worship out from our belly, right? Out of living waters come out from our belly. So we know that. We talk about that. Worship also in spirit. You would say, you know, when we were saved, God make a deposit to us. And this is our down payment. That's the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And so a lot of, even I was asking, okay, so I know God is in me. So why do I need to go in a corporate, you know, settings like this,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, I need Holy Spirit coming down, and I need to do that, you know. And I believe truly that, yeah, we're carrying it. And it's just in the Bible. It says, when two or three are gathered,
mm-hmm.
I'm in the midst of them.
Yes.
Right? So, I mean, it's effective, but I think when in a corporate setting, right, there's just more power. You know what? Because there's more power to it. Because for me, it's infilling. You know, we can go through all thing, our job or whatever we're going through. And like Pastor Orlando was saying about that spirit, right? About the waters pouring in. And you always have to be full. So us, we cannot, the reason why we do that, for us to be always full, right? Because if we don't do that, then you share because you're overflowing.
Yeah.
You know, you share because you don't, you know, you share because you don't go so that you can share. You know, your overflowing shares automatically. It shines what, you know, what you have. When even the apostles, when they had so much that when they walk, they have so much power that, right? We know that, you know, their shadows heal people. Because they have so much. I want something like that.
Yeah.
You know, we want something like that. We want the presence of God in us in full.
Mm-hmm.
Right? In full. Like Jesus Christ, when the Spirit come upon Him, He says the Holy Spirit in full came into Him. That's why he can do a lot of things. Nothing's impossible for Him during that 3.5 years of ministry, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because He's in full. And the same thing with the apostles, you know, they were not doing it not until they got received the Holy Spirit, right? So it's very, very important. And I don't say this like, okay, we worship so that we can get something from it, right? I mean, you want to do that because you want to, just like what Maya says, you want to be face-to-face with our Creator. You want to face-to-face with God. When we get into that room, right, our atmosphere changes and we meet face to face. The other thing too, when we meet face to face, every time we come in and we do this, you know, after we have that encounter, it's not the same. You come in as you are, but when you leave this place, you're not the same, because something just fall off on you. You know, that's something like, as we come to Him, as we meet Him, we become more like Him, right?
Yeah.
You know, He just like, you know, that's what He said, there's deliverance. You know, we got delivered from this. I've been having this baggage, man, for a while, and it's just fall off of me. It's like, how come you don't get angry anymore? It's like, you know, I had that before, but I think I went Sunday or something, right? You know, like,
yeah.
So, you know, so it, so you get that too. But Myra's saying, worship out of love, not because we get something, but worship out of love. So we get, you know, so we get deliverance, we get healing, we get this, and we meet Jesus, and we become more like him every time in a corporate setting. And every time, even if you are, you know, as you come to him and get to know him,
right.
He, you know, he will teach you, you know, who is Christ.
Amen.
You know, because we were supposed to look like Christ.
We should look like
Christ. Right? So, I lost my thought, train of thoughts, but, so one more thing that I want to bring up real quick, Maya brought up about God of order, right? So with enter his gates, this is Psalm 100, enter his gates, the praise and worship, on the first page. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise, right? And we were talking about the key. This is one of the key. You need a key to enter the gate. And what is that? This is thanksgiving. Be thankful. You know, you basically try to remember, be thankful. Before you can, you know, be thankful of what God has done to you. Be thankful. For me, it's like, okay. I woke up this morning, I'm still good. You know, God, you provide all my needs, you know.
Yes.
Oh, man. All those things, right? You enter his gates with all this thanksgiving. And then when he gets into his presence, that's when we start giving him praise. That's what the enter his gates, that's the order, right? And when his presence comes, we get into a prophetic worship. Listen, because by the time we already started talking about the thanks, the praise. When we praise, we give him. It's our time for talking.
Mm-hmm.
God is sovereign, so you know we do have order. Like, okay, we sing this song, we sing three songs. But my role is to say it can be one song, it can be three songs. So let's not get used to having, you know, three songs all the time or four songs. You know, if you listen to the Hillsong band or team, worship team, they said, where would you put that song? Number one or number two, or like the last song is always number four. So I can put this song, if it's new, I put it number two or three. So they have something like that, but at Bethel, they don't. They can worship in one song, but they prepared seven songs or, you know, more, even more, but they can do just one. You know, so it always changes, and we just be flowing in right? So we just need to listen.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing that we were talking also, and this is what I noticed, I first saw it when there was a Jesus conference that I saw, and it was Bill Johnson, Benny Hinn, and Lou Engle they were like the senior pastors, and then all the upcoming pastors, they have all those they have this conference. So Lou Engle, Bill Johnson, and Benny Hinn, they were asked, what kills the worship, right? What kills the what stops the worship?
I
said it was
the
first two rows. So if you are in the first two rows, make sure that you fill those rows with people that worship.
Yes.
Engage, right?
That's great.
Yeah. So we started talking about that in Reseda.
Yeah.
And actually we talked
it.
To it is the Sister Glea. Sister Glea, it's not your Sunday, right? But you have to sit in the front.
Yeah.
Work well last Sunday. Yeah. Everyone was like, because I noticed is, you know, the presence comes down, it's this right here, everyone's doing it. Feel like the overflow just comes. So whatever the people comes on the backside, people that are probably new, that's visiting or something like that, they get the overflow.
Take note,
right?
Ushers. Don't put the new ones in the front.
Yes. Actually, in Bethel, when we went there, they have reserve.
They
have reserve. They have
reserve.
And all the people that sits on the front, they are all part of the worship team. Or people that actually going to the school, because they have school there. You know, school of worship, right?
Actually, I think that is a good way, because sometimes the attendees, that newcomers, if
Yeah. So on Reseda, you know, and here maybe we'll start doing that.
Yeah.
The other thing too that I want to add to that is maybe we'll start like, yeah, we know it's sometimes after we worship, mm-hmm. we normally do our handshake
yeah.
and our advertisement.
So it kills.
So that kills the presence
yeah.
also. So maybe we can do that in front before we even
That's
start.
That's what we already talked
yeah,
about.
Okay, good.
Yeah,
yeah so. All in one spirit.
Yeah.
Okay, so we talk. I talk about a lot, a little bit of my personal
yeah.
worship, right? So, if you have any questions or comments, you can say, you know, and. Yeah, if I can answer the pastor and Hayar is here, and we have the worship team here, the whole team is here, so they should be able to answer, right? Before I go into the corporate worship a little bit, so I just want to add to the things that we already talked about. And I think Pastor also talked about this, is, you know, worshiping in spirit, we're not supposed to disconnect, but we sometimes we disconnect, you know. This will always walk in spirit, we'll always be in spirit. What does that mean? You know, Bill Johnson was saying, if you have a dove right here, you know, and that dove is the spirit, what would you like, what would
How
you
would
do?
You walk?
How you would
walk?
You would walk so that it won't fly, it won't go away, right? So you would walk always that your mind, every step that you do, you always like, you know, stepping in your mind that that's there.
Yeah.
So that's like, you know, that's how he demonstrates
yeah,
it.
Yeah.
That we be more conscious,
mindful.
That the mindful, like you, mindful that the Spirit's with us, and
yeah.
we always mindful and we always be listening,
yeah.
always, you
yes.
know, listening
yes.
when we walk, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so I think if we go, like on Sunday, starting tomorrow, you know, and I think Myra already mentioned this, that if you disconnect, get connected.
Get back.
Meaning, you know, do your reading, whatever we talk about
yeah,
waiting and getting connected,
mm-hmm.
Whatever you do, you pray, you read the Bible, you listen to God, you pray, you know, you do your worship at home already, but by the time you get here, you're ready to go.
Prepared
already.
Yes,
you know, it's
yeah.
gonna be the worship team will be really, really appreciate, you know, if everyone
God will appreciate
and God will be appreciate that too. Because
yeah.
the reason I said that because the worship leader has the burden always, you know, to try to carry everybody, you know. It's for everybody.
I think, you know, we begin to understand that the they lead us, but they're not responsible to carry all of us.
Yes.
We are all responsible to carry the glory and the presence of God together. Yes, she has a
question.
You have waiting for his presence,
mm-hmm.
but we already said his presence is already here.
Yes.
What do you wait, right?
So why are we waiting?
We wait because God is omnipresent, right? He can be present everywhere. My understanding, this is what I this coming from me, right? When we get the Holy Spirit in us, it's a deposit, it's a seal.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't mean that we can't be filled. Right? So there's God is a spirit, He's everywhere, right? So when we come, we want more of that. So we wait for His presence to get filled some more.
In
feeling. For some more filling,
oh,
right?
So
it's not just coming from us. For some more, because you get some. Yeah, you're waiting.
More.
That's why you for more. That's why you know you're waiting
for
more.
Actually, what you do when you wait, you've seen people, the waiters, right?
Mm.
What they do?
Mom,
what's your order?
You.
Do you want coffee?
You.
Do you want? Or do you want to wait for what? You know, you are actively allowing God you're actively ministering to him by allowing him, his presence to become more full, more tangible, like the song he was singing. The Shekinah glory is another word, another Hebrew word for presence. Because there is a presence and there is a presence.
Yeah.
And you activate that when you wait, when you're right just like there, you know, like what he was saying, he would probably get a music, you know, as a background, just to steer the Spirit of God in you and to create the atmosphere. And you join that. That's waiting. That's waiting. You know, sometimes we just go blood, you know, just go there. No, you wait. You wait. Meaning, you listen to what he's about. Maybe he wants you to sing. Maybe he wants you just to listen. Maybe he wants you to speak. Maybe he wants to speak. So you kind of wait. And as you do that, the build-up of his presence rises up. You know, that's part of being reverent. You just don't rush. Just like, you know, if someone is speaking, you just don't stand up, you know.
You just want us to listen.
You kind of wait until there is a pause, and then you kind of.
No, thank you.
But you're correct too.
So when we're waiting, part of that waiting is setting the atmosphere, this place,
mm-hmm.
that he can will and he can come.
Yeah.
And one of that is stirring up ourselves, stirring the Spirit inside us.
Mm-hmm.
And so what we do, what like Father Ted was doing,
mm-hmm.
declaring praise,
mm-hmm.
you know, giving thanks, declaring praise, and that stirs up the atmosphere.
Mm-hmm.
Now you can also do that. He just doesn't need to do that. You can do that. That's what we, you know, if you don't know what to say, tongues.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Chandala, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, just declare. Just, but what we cannot do in a worship is not say something.
Yeah.
Right? You know.
Okay. Elaboration on that. There are times when you can also be still, but you need to know when that is, and that's when you begin to really practice worshiping God. You begin to really be sensitive to what he's saying. That's why earlier they were saying, you know, you can start being prophetic. And what he means by that is that, you know, God speaks to all of us.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes you feel like, oh, I have a word for Marlene, you know. Or you just have a word, and maybe that's just one word.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe it's just saying glory. And you go, what would I say, glory? But the minute you say glory, you just say glory, the rest of the words will start coming and join the word. So you just have to put your trust in God. You open yourself, and then God's going to go through. But when you hesitate, then you just grieve the Spirit. And so whatever he wants to say to everybody is quenched. That's why, yeah? You understand that? That's a responsibility. Yep. Quench the Spirit of God. That's why some healings are supposed to happen, but because people hesitated, the healing was quenched. So you do damage in the Spirit. You do damage in people. This is not a light thing, really. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, Dave, your
thank
turn.
You. So, you know, we know it's kind of say like people would probably say, no, before I asked myself also when I first just started, you know, mom always says, you know, God tells me this, or God said, you know, right? God spoke to me. And so for me, because I was so young back then, Christian-wise, I guess like, How do you do that, man?
Even Jesus
talked to you. And then I still be asking people, you know, and they said like, okay, yeah, you can read the Bible. That's how, you know, say, okay,
yeah.
Good, that's good, which is
Russia.
Good actually, right? And then I started learning, like, oh yeah, there's also a spoken word, which is the rhema word, right? So we know that. So we know how to listen. So if we know how to listen, it's the same thing listening when we're worshiping. So we know when. So how do we know? How do we know? It's the same thing as His presence coming down.
Mm-hmm.
I cannot teach something like that because you have to experience it,
mm-hmm.
right? You have to experience it, and very fortunately, that this church, even if we're small, the presence is here. Even the UK, visitors that we had,
mm-hmm.
they would feel the anointing of God coming in this place. You know, people would come in here and cry out, and they don't know why they're crying.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the presence of God is here, so we know that. We also, you know, if you can go to a place, then we see it's like pretty dry. What is dry? Like the presence of God wasn't there. They're all just, you know, they're talking, they were worshiping, a full band and all this stuff, and there's nothing happening. You know, you can just feel that it's dry. These people were talking and they're making jokes, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen that, you know. So it becomes, we know when this presence, when we can feel it, you know, that that His presence is more, you know, it's more, you know, it's more, it's tangible around our place. You would know. Sometimes you can feel like it's electricity. Your hair's, you know, it's like, you would know when the presence of God is here.
May
so
I say something?
Yeah.
It's not a question. Like you were saying, how many songs do you need to sing or something? It's not, it's not the number of songs that, you know, it is the, you know, when the presence of the Holy Spirit is there, you know, when the presence of the Lord, because that's why Pastor always encourages us to be close to God, because you become sensitive to the presence of the Lord.
That's correct.
Then you would know.
That's correct. So when Brother Ted was singing last Sunday, he was just declaring,
mm-hmm.
he could have stopped there, and we don't have to sing. He was just declaring that it can feel, you know, the environment,
yeah,
you know, the whole atmosphere
yeah.
changed, you know, and he knows too,
mm-hmm.
so it's like, oh, because he was saying, the presence of the Lord is here, we haven't even sang a song,
like this morning,
you know, we haven't even sang a song, right, so,
this morning is very strong presence,
yes.
of
yeah,
God.
So, you know,
yes.
coming,
yeah.
being ready also
mm-hmm.
is,
yeah.
the other thing too, that one time we did something like that, when we were going, we used to minister the pastors, meeting on Saturday, and one time we were just like we were just
yeah.
practicing, and then Sam came in. Like, I thought you guys were on full worship. So like what? As soon as I came in the door, I can feel the presence. He was just still like way up there, you
right,
know,
right, yeah.
you know, and it's and then when I would talk to Mom about this, and I said, you know, it could be the people that's in there,
mm.
that's, you know, they have their own, because they're pastors, you know, a lot of these people are ready when they got there already, you know. The worship team is also, you know.
Part of that is the authority that some people carry.
Mm-hmm.
Like, remember, I would tell you, some of you, hey, you guys, when you're going for vacation or go here, go there, you know, it would be wonderful if you tell me, because when I'm carrying a different kind of message, I need certain people to be there, because you have a weight, you have your gift, and your calling adds to that, and so I'm able to deliver the message, you know, in a different way.
That's why sometimes you ask.
Yeah.
If you can
sometimes I ask you, can you just stay? Because I have this.
Yeah.
That's important. I haven't taught you guys on that, but
no,
those are important. But yeah,
yeah,
here and there. So that's important. Like when we were together when I ministered to a pastoral conference in Dumaguete, and Dave and Christine were going, "What was that?" You know,
mm-hmm.
you know, we've never seen you like that, because the anointing I carry is going to be different when I'm just here in our local church. And when I go to a different venue, the anointing is totally different. It's just, it would just explosive. And so they were kind of shocked, because that's the first time they saw me minister in a big congregation, in a big conference. But the difference there too is because I'm ministering to pastors and leaders, and they carry authority and weight themselves. So the delivery and the move of the Spirit's different.
So, just like what we all closed up, living in a life of worship, Romans 12:1,
yeah.
Right? Our life supposed to be a worship, a sacrifice. So why do you think we had this morning, we had like, or I just said this morning. Why do you think there's a hesitation? There was quietness and there's some type of hesitation. The reason why I think there's a hesitation because sometimes people are like, okay, maybe I can't sing this song, or what, this is a new song, or whatever, or I, you know, I might not say the right words, or you know, you just don't have that confidence. But if you're doing that personally, you know who you are in Him because you have that relationship.
Yes.
So
yes.
No one, like Brother Ted, he would just cry out. He doesn't care about anyone. We are all in one family, right?
Mm-hmm.
But for him, all he cares, you know, it's a face-to-face encounter. So he cares, he cries out. And that's what how we should, like when we worship, we unveil everything, you know, everything that's in us. You know, just lay it, everything down. You know, don't care about who this is or this guy is or what they're going to say. You know, I was crying or I was doing this, I was, you know, doing that. But, you know, we should have that confidence. You know, and if we still have that, let's pray, break that down.
Mm-hmm.
If the old man's still there, kill him. what is that old man? I still have that little pride in me. What are they gonna say when I say something?
Kill
right?
The old man.
That pride. You know.
Right.
Yeah. So what is that pride? That pride. Who has the pride? The old man still have the pride, right?
Pride and baka mali yung sasabihin.
Exactly.
Actually, that's also fear of man.
Like that's
yeah,
true.
Fear
yeah.
of man.
Rather
right.
than
yeah.
fear of God, by allowing Him to be praised when you speak it, you are afraid of
what
other people may think of you.
Yes.
Yes. So
we got to be free from that.
Yeah, we got to be free
Who
from
cares?
That.
Who cares? After
yeah.
all, somebody is going to be helped by what you're going to say.
We do more of this, and every Friday, once a month, Friday, you know, be delivered from all that stuff, you know, and just be free in His presence. Let's be free. We know who we need to give praise to. We don't have to give praise to other people. You know, we don't have to be watchful of what they're gonna say to other people.
Yeah.
You know, it's between you and God. When you come here, it's between you and God. It's a personal encounter. Why do we do this? Just like I said, it's out of love, right? And then he said the first, when Abraham did the first worship sacrifice, right? He did it by listening also, but the thing is, he did it in obedience. Yeah, this is an obedience. We obey what he said. You know, he designed us to do this worship, to worship, and we love him. He said, "When you love me, obey my commands." Right?
Amen.
So I want to close with that.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.